Red Wings fans, stand up. Yeah, we gonna throw them wings up.
Wings up, wings up.
Show the league that this is our time. Let's make the city proud. We gon' win the Stanley Cup.
Stanley Cup, Stanley Cup.
After that we gonna party. We gon' show everybody. We show them all around the world.
We show them all around the world.
We show them all around the world. We gon' throw them wings up. We gon' throw them wings up,
being a late scratch in Edmonton, is on defense along with Trevor Daley. The Vancouver Canucks counter with Brandon Sutter in the middle. Michael Furland is on the wing for him. He got hit hard. Mantha tried to clear. He couldn't. The Canucks with it. Back of the net. Centering right out front and off the post. Great opportunity for J.B. to
get a goal, actually.
For confidence alone.
Oh, boy.
Bertuzzi. Looks back. Hronek across the shot. Scores! Mantha!
Hallelujah. Beat up for him, actually. But man, oh man, he is able to step right into that thing. That thing's going over 100 miles an hour. Perfectly set up right into his wheelhouse. And he didn't even get everything on it. But it was perfectly placed. And it's a 5-on-3 goal, so they'll remain on the power play.
Myers, Howard, good save. I don't know if he saw it. The shot just goes wide.
Well, they had lots of traffic there. Good job by Vancouver.
What a look pass. Larkin, Mantha, he's in the clear. Save made by Markstrom. What a pass and what a take on. Hirose heads to the front of the net. I happen to see you down low. He's got it. Hirose. Or Cholowski. He walks right in. Scores! A 5-on-3 power play goal and now a 4-on-3 power play goal.
Looks like this puck went off a stick. Yeah, Edler not happy, but you know what? Just the rub of the green. There it is right there. The deflection off Edler's stick and no chance for a goaltender unless it hits him. And Cholowski makes it 2-0, another power play goal. So one of our Taco Bell takes.
No, not a lot.
Not a lot.
DJ had worked with Mike Nolan, Toronto, not a lot. No. Into the slot, good save, Howard again. Besser. Back for Horvat. Right through the middle, and a nice play and a good save off Miller by Howard. Howard the save, looking for it, he's got that. With Miller right. Puck's gonna have some pieces taken out of
it.
Horvat with two, Horvat with three, Patrick.
Boy.
Bo Horvat, his third of the night, into the empty net, 5-2 Vancouver.
Which would have made it 3-0, and this game would have been over.
As the Vancouver Canucks will end their road trip in victorious fashion to improve to 6-3.
Going early on, how gratifying was it to get the power play clicking tonight in that stage?
Yeah, we needed it. Lately we haven't been the best, and we've been dangerous sometimes, but we haven't been scoring, so tonight was good for us for sure.
Were you surprised you had that much open ice on your goal?
Yeah, I got the puck and the seas kind of parted. Nobody came to me, so I figured I'd walk in and shoot it.
What happened on the bench when they made it 3-2 and then right away 4-2?
Not a lot. It was just kind of two plays that just kind of went in. We were still, working hard. We were still playing well. And they just got those two goals, and I don't think we were deflated, but, 4-2 with not much time left, it's hard to come back.
I can't think this team's confidence is very high right now on a 5-game losing skid, and maybe have, 6 goals in that span?
Yeah, but, we know we have the players and the skill in here to, be able to bounce back. So we can't let our, mindset or confidence get down, and we just have to move on to the next game and keep going.
Dennis, where do you think
you know, after Montreal, there was, you know, a sense of renewal here. Where do you think it's gone wrong for the Red Wings? Is it something that you fellas aren't doing, or is it the opposition is playing you a little differently?
It could be a bit of both, really. One of the biggest things, we got to score more goals. You know, we had a couple tonight, but and you know, obviously keep the puck out of our net too. You know, we have to, you know, if we're going to be a good team, we have to keep it out of our net and then, you know, create those chances off of turnovers and counter.
Period. You know, I think two cheap penalties where we weren't just, they didn't mean to make the mistakes there, but, you know, 1 second left and we get a tripping call and then errant stick and we get a high sticking and their power play, but it was the factor there. So, you know, I thought we had a couple good shifts after they tied it 2-2, and but that third and fourth goal were tough.
Dylan, you guys keep talking about when you play the right way, you're a good team, but it seems like more and more distance is growing between your last 60-minute effort and...
Yeah, it is. I think we played the right way the first two periods, and then it was a... you know, it was a special teams match, and they were on top. And it's a game where there's a lot of penalties, a lot of penalty kill. It's hard to fall asleep and get away from your game at 5-on-5. And but those two power play goals by Vancouver there killed us.
What issues are you still seeing on the PK that need to be resolved here?
I mean, I think we're taking too many penalties to begin with. So we can kill off two or three, but when it gets up to five or six penalties, it's so hard. And those guys are playing big minutes. They're sacrificing their bodies. And when you give good players the puck that much for I don't know how many penalties we took, but I looked up and it was 14 or 16 minutes. We give their best players the puck that long. It's, you know, they're going to make something happen. So we got to stay out of the box and stay way more disciplined.
Is the biggest test right now mental toughness? To not let this fester.
You know, we have a game tomorrow. You know, we're playing a team in Ottawa. It's a building we've had success in the past couple of years. So right now we need 2 points in the worst way, and you know, that's our focus right now. Is we're going to battle hard tomorrow, and we need those two points. We got to be desperate from the start.
Yeah, and just along those lines, how much are you paying attention to the standings? I know it's early, but just not letting too much separation take place right there at this point in the schedule.
It's early, but we're going on the road tomorrow night, and then we're home for a little bit, and we got to fix our game at home. And you know what? I think you saw our home opener; we were really good, and since then we haven't been good enough at home. So we need to get a big 2 points, get our confidence back tomorrow night in Ottawa, come back home for a week, and make something happen, and play our game, and stay disciplined. And we've been getting good goaltending, so we need to score, and we need to, like, stay disciplined and play our game.
Is it a matter of just getting more speed into your game too? Because you guys are can be a very fast team.
Yeah, we can. When we play fast, we're a good team. Tonight it's tough. So much power play, so much penalty kill. It was a slow game. It was a boring game at times. But when we need to score, we need to score on the power play. And tomorrow night we need to have a fast start and play a fast game.
Yeah, I know you're disappointed right now, but are you at least encouraged that, you know, you were able to get a couple of power play goals tonight?
We need more. I think when that power play we had late in the third, that was our chance. That's when you know, a big power play comes out and comes over the boards and scores. And we didn't have that. We did get a couple 5-on-3, but we still need to be better 5-on-5 or 5-on-4 and getting into the zone easier.
You said after the Montreal game, you know, your identity is never going away. Is that what you kind of need to recapture?
Yeah, we do. Absolutely. We need to do that. And we'll see it tomorrow night. We need to come out and play that relentless game tonight. We played it for 40 minutes, but we need to put together an effort for 60 minutes, and that's what it comes down to in this league.
2-0 lead. I thought we were doing, you know, a lot of good things going into the third period. You know, we give them two power play goals, which you know, we can't allow. It's as a penalty killer, take responsibility. We gotta, you know, make sure that we're all sacrificing blocking shots. You know, and that gave them the momentum. And but you know, it's. We know in here when we play the right way, we can be a good team, and you know, we can't you know, let it unravel like that in the third period for us. You know, we had chances. We have a lead. We gotta make sure that you know, I thought our power play did a great job tonight. Got us, you know, some goals, and we gotta make sure you know, penalty kill. We hold up our end. We make sure that you know, as a unit of four out there, we're all you know, doing a great job.
It just seems like there's more and more distance between the last time you guys played well as a team.
For 60 minutes, yeah, for sure. You know, I know we talk about that Montreal game, but you know, we played fast. We were above guys. We create a lot of opportunities and chances, and you know, right now it's we got to make sure that you know, it's a next shift mentality. I know we've talked about that a bit too, but you know, we got to go out. If we get scored on, we got to go out and make sure that we're even better the next shift. No excuses. We're at home. We got to, you know, be able to handle stuff like that and momentum swings.
Jimmy really played well, especially the first couple of periods, and then a couple of bad bounces went against you. The one off of Hronik's skate comes to mind. How much did those kill momentum as far as that goes, Justin?
Yeah, it's just we talk about that a lot, you know, for ourselves offensively. It's just getting pucks towards the net and getting those breaks. So you can't ever control breaks in hockey, but you just got to, you know, make sure you go out and do it right and put yourself in good positions. And, you know, hey, listen, I think we can continue to do more of that ourselves, get pucks around the net and get some breaks and bounces. But we got to continue to work on, you know, playing for 60 minutes, you know, staying within our game, doing it together out there. You know, and if we things go wrong for a shift, we got to make sure that next shift's you know, a great shift for us. And you know, we got to make sure, like I said, that next shift mentality is huge. And when we do it right, you know, feel really good about this team and how we can play. We're still early in the season, so we got to learn from these last number of games and you know, be a better team because of that.
Justin, how disappointing is it? You know, you finally exercise that demon of the Bell Center. You think that you're, you know, you guys are maybe hitting a bit of a stride, and then to go on a five-game slide.
Yeah, it's like I said, you know, when we play the way we're capable of playing, you know, I think we can be a really good team. We're fast. You know, I think we get in the ozone. We can do a lot of great things. We can hang on to pucks, you know, and make it hard on teams. But we got to continue to focus on making sure we're a clean hockey team. You know, limit our turnovers, you know, everywhere around the rink, and play to our strength. And you know, I think most importantly, like I said, just make sure we're going out and you know, doing it each and every shift. And you know, playing within our structure.
We carried the play for two periods. We're the better team. Certainly had more chances. We're on the power play, have chance to score. We take a penalty with a second left. You know what I mean? Like, so now you come in and you're shorthanded and do a pretty good job on the kill. Then they score at the end. They score again on the next penalty kill. So all of a sudden the game starts to turn. Now it's an even game. I thought Lark's line had a couple of good shifts in there, but then they score again. And the more you start getting scored on, you don't score, the more the momentum goes away from you, and that's what happened.
Larkin also made the point of taking too many penalties and giving too many good power plays opportunities to beat your team. How can you clean that up for your guys?
We'll work on it. I mean, yeah, you can't give up that many power play opportunities, you know. So, you know, some of them are, you know, the high stick. I got to watch it again. Is it careless? I got to see, you know. Certainly the mentality. I know what Bert's doing. He's trying to win the puck battle, but you got to know the clock a little bit. You can't want to try so hard that you take a penalty on the power play. You just can't do it.
Even after the tie, there was still a lot of time.
Mm-hmm. Well, they certainly had momentum for a little bit, no doubt about it. You know, a few shifts in a row, and then I thought Lark's line went out and did a good job and had a chance to gather some momentum back, and then you get scored on. So how did we respond? You know, if we score, I think we grabbed the momentum back, we got scored on, and the momentum continued to go the wrong way. Well, again, we gotta. To me, it so much comes down to, you know, when you give up as many goals as we've given up, and enough of it's been on the penalty kill, it crushes you. So like in Montreal, they score, we come back and score. The momentum in games is such a huge deal when teams are as close as all these teams are. So when you're getting scored on as many times you've gotten scored on, it's hard to keep digging back out. It just is, and we don't score easy. So we got to find a way to either get more scoring. You know, I think Lark's line is done a really good job, but we need more scoring throughout the lineup. Or two, we got to do a better job of giving up less goals. Now, a majority of that in a number of the games, certainly if you look at the two Vancouver games, that comes down to penalty kill. You know, like that comes down to three goals on one game and two on another that are critical moments in the game. So we got to do a way better job of that. Yeah, you know, Svech, I thought, played good early. It's hard. He didn't play much after that. Just the way the specialty teams went, it's hard. It's if you're not on either unit, it gets really hard. You know, I thought Helmer was playing real good, but if you're not on either unit, which he's not right now, it gets real hard. So, you know, I think we got to look at our personnel and our kill. That doesn't necessarily affect Svech, but it certainly affects Helmer. You know, does Helmer get back on the penalty kill and get more opportunities? Overall, from Svech's standpoint, I thought he did a pretty good job. Yeah, I think he just took a stinger, is my gut. Yeah, I don't have any report further than that.
How about the Kaiser?
Right now, you know, he obviously didn't finish the game, so I should know more tomorrow where he stands. I talked to John after Steve talked to John. My message to John was, you know, depending on what happens with waivers, which is something you never know, go down and play great hockey. And he told me that's his plan. And, you know, he just hasn't played in a long time. And right now I didn't have him in the lineup. So if you don't have him in the lineup, he's got to play in order to get himself his game back going. He's got to play. He hasn't played since March. So now he gets to go down and play hockey and hopefully play great hockey. He'd be super happy and we'd be super happy if he went down there and played great. And then, you know, then he's able to get back in the lineup at some point. But right now it's go down and play great hockey. The only thing is that doesn't give credit to Ottawa. They're going to work their asses off, and they're going to play hard. And they're a young team that has a lot that's not totally dissimilar to us in terms of the arc. We're probably further ahead of that, but they've got some real young talented players. So I want to make sure, like, if we think we can go out and just dictate the game and it's going to be easy, we're crazy. We got to go out and from the start of the puck or to the end of the game, play great hockey to give ourselves the best chance to win. It's going to be a battle tomorrow night, and we got to be ready for that.
I know it's early, but how much are you paying attention to the need for 2 points right now and minimize the separation that takes place in the standings?
For sure. This is what we're trying to pay attention to is the game that's ahead of us, and so we got to find a way. You know, this one sucks. Like, that's a hard game to lose. There isn't anybody in that room that did, like, that sucks. There's no doubt about it. So, but it's going to be over tomorrow. Like, we're going to review it. We're going to look at ways we can get better. Well, one, staying out of the box. We're going to do all those things. Then we got to find a way to win a game in Ottawa. We got to focus on winning that game, period.
Thank you.